remote operation is the future way of having offshore cranes.
Wow. Where do you begin with a design like this?
So we're heading to Stavanger and my chariot awaits.
Yes.
All right, let's do it. Full speed ahead.
I'm Daniel from Ashville and I'm in Norway with PALFINGER. If you remember last year, they taught us all about remote operated cranes. Click here to watch that video. Well, I'm here to dig a little deeper and find out some more information. Let's go and have a look. Hello.
Hello.
I'm Daniel.
I'm Sonia. Nice to meet you. Welcome to PALFINGER MARINE Norway.
Hello.
Hi.
I have heard a lot about remote cranes. What can you tell me about them?
We have received a frame agreement contract a few months ago from Aker BP, where we have to deliver 6 cranes for this project. So for them, they will have more and more unmanned platform in the future. And for them, the remote operation is the future way of having offshore cranes. So with Aker BP, we have 3 types of crane. And I propose maybe that I show you on the screen a bit what we have, the different types, so you can visualize them.
Yes, please.
So we have a jib crane. This is the very new type of crane that we have developed. We have a Royal Laughing crane. This is a very traditional lattice boom crane that we see on the offshore environments. And we also have as well a world running crane, which will be mainly for onboard operation.
Okay, now how are these cranes powered?
Those are fully electrical driven.
Fully electric?
All of them, yes. You only have electromotors, drives on the cranes, and you get power from the platform.
Wow.
This is as well an example for remote operation, how you will be sitting in a desk, how you will see the crane. We have different cameras around the crane. We will have different assistance functions for the crane. We have a collaboration with Optilift, which will provide special sensors for the crane to know where the crane is, to know which container to lift at the right moment to lift, and to make the operation simpler and safer from the shore.
Okay, so you've shown me these 3 great cranes. Can you tell me, will all of them be operated from onshore?
No, not all of them. 2 of those types will be operated from onshore control room. We will have the wire laughing crane, those type of cranes, and the jib crane. And I suggest that we have a look with my colleague Chatil. He can present you a bit more this new type of cranes that we have made for especially remote operation.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah, let's go. Hello, Chatil.
Hello.
Daniel? Oh, wow. Look at this. Where do you begin with a design like this? What's the starting point? Did you have anything to go by or did you begin this design from scratch?
This particular design was started from scratch. So it begins looking something like this.
Wow. So this was the starting point for the jib crane?
This was the starting point for the jib crane.
Now tell me, what has your involvement been in this design I'm looking at?
In the sales phase, what we approached with the client was the unmanned operation and remote operation.
Okay.
So how to make a crane fitting for having less maintenance possible, to protect everything as much as possible. And of course, as it's fully electrical, then you have much less maintenance. You don't have oil on the crane, you only have electrical equipment.
At what point does the client see this design?
I think they have been heavily involved since day one.
Since day one?
Yeah.
So you've made this in collaboration with the client?
Yes.
Okay. And can the client make changes or recommendations?
Oh, yes, they are.
They are, definitely, yeah? Okay. And what are their recommendations based on? The exact application, what they're going to be using it for, which their team will be using it?
Yeah, I would say so, but also based on experience from crane operators, which are, you know, dealing with cranes.
Okay, so I've seen this impressive crane, but I actually want to get out there. I want to smell the sea. You know, I want to get a feeling of where this crane is going to be.
Yeah.
Can we go out there?
Yeah, let's go there. My colleague Jalen is waiting for you at the harbour.
Great. My man, thank you so much for your time. Appreciate you.
Yeah.
See you soon.
All right, bye.
So, you must be Jan.
Correct. You're Daniel. I recognize you.
Yes. How you doing, my man?
I'm doing good.
I hear you've got something fun in store for me.
Yes. We are going to Stavanger to meet Aker BP.
Okay.
We found a bit of an untraditional way of going. So we are going by the boat.
Okay, well, clearly we must be in a bit of a rush because this doesn't look like it's going to be taking its time.
This is a fast one.
So we're heading to Stavanger and my chariot awaits.
Yes.
All right, let's do it. We have a supply vessel, and what is the primary function of the crane on the rig?
The primary function of the crane is, of course, to bring cargo on and off the rig from these kind of vessels. It's not exactly these vessels. These are anchor handlers, but they look the same as these, more or less.
Okay, and where would the crane be situated?
The crane would be situated on the platform. It would be something like 60 to 70 meters above the deck of these vessels.
What would be lifted onto the rig? Is it important, and how heavy would it be?
It's anything from normal food containers to supplies to bigger special lifts. Could be generators, could be heavy stuff that weighs up to 60, 70 tons.
Now, Jan, bear with me. So we're out at sea, the supply vessel's there. We're moving, yeah?
Yeah.
So how is the system gonna work around the movement which is happening at sea? Because that's something that you can't really account for, is it?
No, it's not. And of course, this is one of the things that makes it a bit dangerous for the people on the deck of these vessels as well, because you have movements, you have containers, you have the crane coming in and picking up. And that's one of the things we're gonna do with this project. We're gonna move the people from the deck. So there's not gonna be anybody there. They're gonna just pick the container on and off without people handling.
You're going to completely remove the people?
Yes.
Okay. Why do you want to do this?
The main reason is due to safety.
Due to safety.
Then you will keep the people away from the dangerous areas.
Okay. Well, Jan, right. I've heard a lot. I would really like to see some of this happening. I'd like to see some action.
Yes. So let's go to Aker BP in Stavanger, this direction.
Full speed ahead! Well, today I'm in Stavanger to meet with PALFINGER's client slash partner, Aker BP.
It's going perfect. Isn't it a bit windy?